Please help others rise. Greatness comes not from a position, but from helping build the future. We have an obligation to pull others up. In this video, we are going to discuss the inspirational story of Mrs. Indra Nooyi. She was a former CEO of PepsiCo, one of the biggest food and beverage companies in the world. And in 2010, she was also rewarded as the 6th rank in the most powerful women in the world. She has inspired crores of people all around the world with her inspirational story. So let us discuss the story of Indra Nooyi in this video. Indra Nooyi ma'am was born on 20th October 1995 in Chennai. With her studies, she also participated in other co-curricular activities, such as she was a part of her school singing band. Also, she was captain of her girls cricket team. After completing BSc from Madras Christian College, she got admission to IIM Calcutta, where she pursued a PG diploma course in management. She initiated her career with a job in the textile industry called Methur Bread Cell, but she was not very happy doing this job. So she moved to a different company called as Johnson & Johnson and played a crucial role in the first sanitary pad launched by Johnson & Johnson called Stay Free. Later, when she was doing this job, her friend circle really pushed her hard to apply for the Yale University in USA. But she didn't want to go there and had no intentions to join the college again. But to her surprise, she also cleared the test and also got some financial help to move to US and complete this course. So finally, she moved to United States in the year 1978 and pursued her master's degree in the public and private management. While she was working and pursuing her degree, she also worked as a receptionist 3 to 4 hours a day to make some good amount of money, because she didn't wanted her parents to pay all her money and her expenses. Also, in the last year of her degree, she also worked as an intern at Booz Allen Hamilton company. And after completing her degree, she wanted to do a job. So she was dressed up in a Western style to fit in the crowd and went for an interview. But to her surprise, she was badly rejected by the interviewer because she was very uncomfortable in her Western clothes and she was very nervous at her interview. Later, on the advice of her professor in her university, she dressed up in a clothes where she was more comfortable, and it was none other than Indian sari. And guess what? She cleared the interview and got a job at Boston Consulting University. Afterwards, she worked with the known firms like Motorola as a strategic planner. Also, she worked in Asian Brown, Boveri and Emerge. During her initial days in her job, she had to face a lot of difficulties because first, she was a non-American and second, she was a woman. But all of these were small in front of her talent and hard work. Her work proceeded with her name, and it was this time that she got attention from two gentlemen called Jack Welch, a former chairman of General Electric, and Wayne Calloway, a former CEO of PepsiCo. She was offered a job at both of these companies, PepsiCo and General Electric, but she decided to go with PepsiCo as a VP of strategic planning. Years passed and her crucial role in bringing the company into the path of success gave her the promotion as a chief financial officer in the year 2000. Later in the year 2006, the CEO of PepsiCo, Mr. Steven Raymond, due to his health issues, resigned from the position of a CEO, and with such an impressive professional career, Indra Nooyi was the best person to fill the vacant seat. She was made a CEO of the firm called PepsiCo, which is already, I have told you, the biggest company in the food and beverages category in the world. Under her leadership and guidance, PepsiCo made a huge profit by acquiring companies such as Tropicana, Quaker Oats and Gatorade. Under her leadership, she also remapped the companies and its products into three categories. First is fun for you, second is better for you, and third is good for you. While being a CEO of PepsiCo for around 12 years, she managed the company to move towards more heights. Under the Indra Nooyi's tenure, PepsiCo made a profit of more than 80%, and here you can read this article. I have put all the articles and my sources and the videos where I found the content in description. Please also check out and read these articles. They will help you a lot. And in In 2018, she stepped down as the CEO of PepsiCo and was offered to be a board of directors at Amazon. And also, she was the second woman to be a part of the board of directors at Amazon. And this makes me so much proud of my nation. With achieving so much in her life, she also was awarded as the CEO of the year in the year 2009. Also, she was elected as a chairwoman as a US Indian Business Council. She was also in the top 50 list by the Wall Street Journal. And also, she made a mark to the second rank in the Fortune Most Powerful Women in the World. And at last, in the year 2007, she was awarded as the Padma Bhushan Award in India. And this was the story of Mrs. Indira Noi. I really get goosebumps when I tell you the story, and I really got motivated while I was delivering this video and also while I was scripting. She had achieved a lot of great success in her life, and such a self-made woman, right? Indira Noi continues to inspire women and men entrepreneurs all over the world. Also, there are links in description of the useful articles and videos. You can watch them and get inspired, get motivated, and get to learn a lot from Mrs. Indira Noi ma'am. And by the way, the video is not ended yet. Yet again, I want you to comment the best takeaways from the video. And if you ask me my takeaways, I will be telling you my takeaways, but just pause the video and comment right now. Just pause the video. 3, 2, and 1. Now let me tell you my biggest takeaways from the journey and the inspirational story of Mrs. Indira Noi ma'am. The first takeaway is when she left her high-paying job at textile industry because she was not very interested and not enjoying her job. The first takeaway is that you need to be happy with what you are doing, and I am a strong believer of this statement. You need to be happy with what you are doing. The second takeaway from the video is that your friend circles matters a lot. All your thoughts and all your comments are the reflection whom you are surrounded with. Indira Noi had a great friends who pushed her hard to answer the Yale University exam. Well, if her friends didn't push her hard to answer this exam, she wouldn't have achieved this success in her life. So the second takeaway from the video is that your friend circles matter a lot. The third takeaway of the video reminds me of the sari incident when first time she was very nervous in the Western clothes, and therefore she was rejected from the interview. And second time when she wore a sari, she was selected and she cracked the interview. So the third takeaway from the video is be yourself. Now let us see some of the clips of Indira Noi ma'am speaking, because my words might not be that much motivating. So let us see.
First, please be a lifelong student. You know, when we are kids, we ask questions like, why is the sky blue? Why is the bird flying so high? But for some reason, as we get older, that curiosity goes away. And if we are happy with the knowledge we have, then we are actually going to atrophy. So please remain a lifelong student. Don't lose that curiosity. Second, whatever you do, throw yourself into it. Throw your head, heart, and hands into it. I look at my job not as a job. I look at it as a calling, as a passion. And I don't care about the hours. I don't care about the hard. So whatever you do, please look upon it as a calling and a passion, not as a job, not as something temporary. The third and the most important one, please help others rise. Greatness comes not from a position, but from helping build the future. All of us in positions of power have an obligation to pull others up. The fourth skill I'd say is consistency. It's important that leaders are consistent. You can change your mind, but change your mind against a consistent framework. Because if you're not consistent, people are always second-guessing what you're doing. So be consistent. And the last skill is your compass. Integrity is critical in this job. You can be competent, you can be courageous, have confidence, be a great communicator, be consistent. But if you don't have integrity, that compass doesn't point true north.
So I hope you have liked the clipping and also this video. Please like the video, share it among your friends, and please share this video with all your family members, friends, and motivate them with an inspirational story of Mrs. Indra Nooyi. She is not much popular in youth, but I have taken this decision to make more videos on such personalities who are not much popular, but their story is very much interesting and inspirational. So please leave a comment in the comment box. What are your biggest takeaways from the video? Lastly, subscribe to my channel for amazing analytical, informative, and technology related videos. This is Jayant signing off. I will catch you guys in the next one. Until then, bye bye.